Hello, my name is Aliyu, Ilias, Customer Experience Management Expert. Today I want to discuss about emotional intelligence and customer experience management. Yes, emotion is what we cannot do without. But the challenge is, how do you recognize if it is positive or negative? When it is negative in business, it could lead to angry, putting up bad attitude, or even not responding while our customer representative is discussing with us. And that is negative emotion. Then positive could be surprise, a sign of gratitude, a sign of satisfaction from what? From the customers. But how do you manage these two? It's very, very key, because if you are serving somebody who is for sure is being influenced by emotion, you need to have self-awareness yourself, self-regulation yourself. You need to know when you are being positive and when you are negative, and also not to transfer aggression. So generally, you need to be able to manage people's emotion. If you recall, there's a particular time that all what you want to wear in the world is polo by Ralph. And by wearing polo by Ralph, you believe everything is perfect. You believe you are wearing the best clothes. In fact, someone that I know very, very well have all his clothes to be polo by Ralph. It then means psychologically, he has emotion that is tilted towards what? Polo by Ralph. So now, how do you now convert it to fantastic customer experience? You have to key into this emotion. That's why most selling point has to do what? You have to capture and key into people's emotion. And that's why most slogans that people use has to do with what? Those emotions. So you have to look at customers' emotion. Is it positive? Is it negative? When you have this, you may have to, like, when it is negative, try to bring it back to neutral state. Because if not bring it back to neutral state, definitely you won't be able to sell to that person. So be super duper and always create a good customer experience. Thank you. Love and strength, and you, me, yeah,